Hello and welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett, and in today's presentation, we're going to take a look at further tuning our bash history. Now, we've previously looked at how we can go through with our bash history and ensure that our memory resident history is kept clear of duplicates. But if we've been working with our history for a little while, we're going to find within their history file, there are still going to be duplicates. So we can look at how, with some clever tricks, we can control that as well. Come on, let's find a command line. And hello and welcome to our Pixel Playground, a playground where we're going to be able to learn a little bit more about what's going on with our history. We've already seen that by working with our hisControl variable, we're able to ensure that we can remove duplicates from our history. But when we go through and take a look at this system, it's very new and it's clean and up and running. We've got very little in our history. When I go through, though, and look at my underlying file, cat.bash_history, this is in my home directory, we can see, well, currently I don't have anything there. So my memory resident history is in my memory, but not in my file at the moment. Well, if I log out, and I could do that just with a control D, it's very simple, then go back in again. Now, when I go through and look at the history command, I'm going to be able to see that, okay, well, at least I've got that history command in my file now. And when I look at the .bash_history file, we can see now that I've got some content in that. And we're going to start thinking then that that's quite good. But if I go through and say run my ls command, my cd command, my ls command, my cd command, now this is what we've already talked about by the idea that we can remove these duplicates, because when I look at my history, we can see then that I have those duplicate commands. Again, if I log out and then log back in again, look at my history, all of that has been written through into my history. Now, even if I go through now and fix up my variable, so let's go through and edit vim and look at our .bashrc file and make sure that we've got then the correct control going on. So we've got the ignore both going on here at the moment. We're going to change this and we're going to put in erase dupes. So we remove all of the duplicates, not just ignore them. And we can then go through and put our ignore space so we can still maintain any command that begins with a space isn't going into our history. So that's good. We can go through and save this. We can source it to read into our environment. So source, escape and dot just to bring back that last argument. So everything is up and running the way that it should be. And if I then type ls and look at my history, we're going to be able to see then that things are starting to look good. We only have history written once and we only have ls written once. We use cd, run ls, look at history. We can see then that we've reduced the amount of history, even though potentially you could say we've issued more commands. Well, let's go through and control D to log out, and then we can log back in again. And now when we go through and take a look at our history, we can see the problem is that we are appending new entries when we log out, but we're still maintaining the old file. So especially if you've been working for a long time, your file is going to be full of duplicates. Now, of course, we could go through and edit the file. Potentially, we could delete the file, start all over again. But if you want to maintain the history, one thing you can consider doing is writing to your logout script, your bash_logout script. What we're going to do when we take a look, let's just go through and use vim.bash and then underscore log out. You see it's got some entries here on Ubuntu anyway, but I'm going to go through and add to the end of the file. Now, the first thing that we're going to do is run a history minus A to append our current history through to our history file. This normally happens on a logout anyway, but we just want to make sure that our history file is up to date. Once that has succeeded, we can go through then and clear our memory resident history. So history minus C. This means then we have nothing in our current history. We're now going to go out and work with our bash history file. We're going to do a sort minus U to make sure that it contains only unique entries. We're going to maintain the order, so minus O. And we, of course, are going to look in our home directory and the dot bash underscore history file. Now, that's the file that we're working with. We can also set that file to be the same file that we are writing to. So we can both sort our file and write back to exactly the same file, should we so wish. This is a really clever bit. So now we're removing any duplicates from our .bash underscore history file. We want to make sure that this now is our current history. So once this is correct, we can then go through and run our history minus R to read in from our history file into our memory. Remember, this all happens during the logout, but now we're making sure that we've got a correct current version of our history, both in memory and a clean version in our history file. So this is the clever stuff. Once we're happy with it, we can go through and save our changes. And then we can exit out. I'm just using a Control D. Now, as we go back in, we're still going to maintain the history. We won't have lost our history. So as I go through then and type history, then we have got our history. But look, we've only got one occurrence of each of our commands. And again, I can go through and run the ls command, look back at my history again. And you can see then that I've only got the one occurrence of that. Well, then as I go through and exit out, so Control and D, clear my screen, go back in again. And then write my history. And look, we can see then that everything is maintained. But you also might look at this and think, well, OK, something strange is going on here. I can see the word history twice. Why are we seeing that twice? Well, I'm guessing probably one of them has a space at the end of it. We can go back and take a look with our history command. And if we go through and pipe the output of history through to OD for octal dump, and minus A so we humans can read it because we can write in ASCII format, and we can see the first occurrence of history is history followed by a space and then a new line. Whereas we look at the next occurrence of history, it's history immediately followed by a new line. So they're not exactly the same command. One is seen as history space, the other one just as history. So everything is correct. But we just have then a little bit of untidiness the way that I've been typing. But hopefully this is giving you a great idea and some things that you can play around with your bash logout file to ensure you've got the correct history maintained in the most effective way.
All that is left to say is thank you for watching. If you've enjoyed this, then you are probably sadder than I first thought. For more of this drivel, please subscribe, like and comment to @theurbanpenguin.